Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another problem. Problem is combination sum 3. So in this problem, we have to find all the valid combinations of k numbers that sum up to n, such that following conditions are true. Only numbers 1 through n are used. So 1 to n numbers we can use, and each number is used at most once. That is, either we can use that number or we do not use it. Okay, so only once we can use that number. And return a list of all possible valid combinations. The list must not contain the same combination twice, and the combinations may be returned in any order. Okay, so see, what does the question is saying is that we have k 3 and n 7. So we have to find a combination of k numbers. Like, there should be only 3 numbers in the combination, and those numbers should sum up to n. So what's the problem? K numbers combination we need to find, and those numbers sum should be equal to n. Alright, so over here there are 3 numbers, k numbers in the combination. So this is one combination, and sum of the numbers are 1 plus 2 plus 4, 7. So this is one valid combination. And one number, like from 1 to n, 1 to 9, each number we can only use once. Okay, or we do not use it. At most once it's written. So now let's see how we can approach this problem. So see guys, whenever, like, these kind of problems are pretty basic, right? So it's clear when we read the problem, it's very much clear that we have different possibilities, right? So what we can do is we can choose any number from 1 to 9. Okay, and we need to make a K number combination. So we have to make a K number combination. That is, so see, 3, here K is 3, right? So I'm taking this scenario that K is 3. So we have to make a combination where there are 3 numbers. So this, at this position, right? At this position, any number from 1 to 9 could come. Can come, right? Any number from 1 to 9 can come. Similarly, at this position, any number from 1 to 9 can come. And at this position, any number from 1 to 9 can come. How you can identify this? If you see the output. See the this output. I have taken this case. So here see. K is 3. So we have to take 3 numbers in a combination, and the sum of those numbers should be 9. So see, 1 plus 2 plus 6, 9, 1 plus 3 plus 5, 9, and 2 plus 3 plus 4, 9. So what is there? These combinations are there. That is 1, 2, 6, 1, 2, there is 1, 2, 6, then there is 1, 3, 5, and then there is 2, 3, and 4, right? So see, if we can clearly see from these output that at this position, any number can come. At this position, any number can come. And at this position, any number can come. Okay. So from this, you can get the intuition that at each position, there could be any number from 1 to 9, 1 to 9, 1 to 9. So whenever these multiple, see, there could be multiple cases, right? 1 could come here, then 2 could come here, or 3 could come here. So when there are multiple cases, what you have to think is of using recursion. Whenever there are multiple cases. So now let's see how you can use recursion over here. So what we need to do is that we have to make combinations, right? So we have to make combinations. So over here, if you see, we have this output array. This is our main vector array, right? And it has different combinations. It has different combinations. So what I will be doing is I will be taking an answer vector or array list or list in Python or Java. So I will be taking this vector, and this will be my combination. Like, this will store my combination, whatever current combination is, like current combination, okay? And I will have a final vector. This will be my output array, like which I will return. This will store multiple combinations, okay? This will store multiple combinations. So what I will do is I will start recursion. So how I will have recursion? So I'll see. Let's assume, just assume that you have to fill, there are three positions, right? You have to fill each of the position. So first you will assume that, let's say from 1 to 9, here 1 to 9 numbers can come, any 1 to 9 numbers. So here you are assuming that you will take 1. So if you fix 1 here, rest of this 2 digits, like total sum should be what? You have to make a combination of numbers such that sum of those numbers is equal to n, right? So if 1 I am fixing here, right now sum is 1. I want that this sum is equal to n. When this sum is equal to n, then that combination I have to take. But that combination should have how many? It should have k numbers, right? So that's also we have to take care of. That the combination should have k numbers. So these two conditions, right? Sum should be, sum of all the numbers should be n, and the numbers in the combination should be k. So let's say I have taken 1 here. From 1 to 9, first of all I have taken this 1 here, so sum is right now 1, and since I have taken 1 digit here, so k will reduce to 2. K is the how many numbers are left, you can say. Okay, so total 3 numbers needs to be there. 1 I have fixed, so rest 2 I have to find out. So now let's say here at the second position, right? Now I'm thinking of the second position. So at the second position I can have what? From 1 to 9 I can have any number, right? So let's say, because I know answer is this one, so I'm just taking here 2. So if I have 2 here, so sum will become 1 plus 2, that is 3. 1 plus 2, 3, and k will reduce to 1. That is now only one digit we need to find, and right now the sum of the combination is 3. Okay, so now what we will do, we'll go to the third digit. So obviously 1 to 9, any number can come here. So for now I am choosing 6. So if 6 comes here, 3 plus 6 will become 9. And now no digit is left. No number needs to be in the combination. So this is C. Now this is our base case. What's the base case? When sum becomes equal to n, that is C. Sum is 9 and n is also 9. And k is equal to 0. Meaning we have all the k numbers in the combination. So if this is a case, then we found a combination, and we will add that combination in our final output array. Final output array is what? Answer 2. We will push back in this right, and this answer, these numbers, right, we will be storing in this vector 1 2 6. So this vector will be there in which we will be storing our answer, and here answer vector we will push in the answer 2. So this answer 2 is a 2D vector, right? It's storing all the combinations. So this combination will get stored in answer 2. So I hope you got some high level idea of how we will approach this problem. Now let's discuss in detail. So if you understood how it's working, you can start writing the code. Otherwise, let's discuss more in detail. What we basically will be discussing, how this tree, recursive tree, we can make. So see, what is there is we have k is equal to 3 and n is equal to 9. I am taking answer vector, which will store my correct combination, and answer 2, which will store my all the combinations, like all the combinations. Okay, so what I will do is, let's say I have this helper function. I have created a helper function in which I will be passing the current sum, whatever the current sum of the combination is, like the combination which is in this vector, whatever the current sum is, current value of k. Okay, and this and I, like basically, this is fine. And obviously these two will be sent, also we'll have in this helper function. So base case, we already saw what will be the base case. So base case will be sum is equal to, if sum is equal to n and k is equal to 0, this will be the base case. So if this is the case, then just add the answer in the answer 2. So answer 2, push back, answer, right? So this will be done. Now, how basically recursion will be working. Let's see that. So see, first of all, we have sum initially zero. Okay, sum initially zero, and k value is 3. So from I will have a loop because at the first position, right? At the first position, we have, let's say we have 3 positions. So at the first position, any number from 1 to 9 can come. So I will try every number, right? I will try every number. I will have a loop which will run from 1 to n. And every time, I will add the, like, if I'm choosing 1 here, I will add that in answer because I will have this 1 as the first number here. Answer dot pushback. I will add 1. And I will increase sum. So sum will become, sum is equal to sum plus 1. So 1 I will take. And k I will reduce by 1. Fine. And I will do recursive call. Recursive call to the, for the next digit. For the next digit. So see how that will work. What we have over here is I'll show one use case. So I'll show for 126. This is one valid combination, right? So I'll show for that. So let's say we have this answer, and we have answer 2. This is a 2D array, right? It will have different combinations. So see, first of all, a loop is running. So from 1 to 9, this loop will run. So first of all, I'm taking this 1. So I'll store that in one answer vector. Answer will have 1, and I will do the recursive call in which sum will become, sum is initially 0, so it will become 0 plus 1, 1, because 1 I have chosen. K will become, k was initially 3, so k will become 2. Right? So now we go to the recursive call. So again we'll enter the same function, and now for the second digit, right? Again, for loop will run. So I can choose 1, I can choose 2, I can choose 3, 4, everything I can choose. So I'll be choosing 2. So 2 I'll choose. Sum will become 1 plus 2, 3. And k will become 1. Right? Sum is 3, k is 1. And then again, we will have recursive call in which sum will, we will pass as 3. And k will become, k will pass as 1. And lastly, again for loop will be there. So for this third digit, obviously we can choose any number from 1 to 9. So I'll be choosing 6. So if I choose 6, sum will become 3 plus 6, 9, and k will be 0. So now again I will do the recursive call. Now it will hit the base case because sum is equal to 9 and k is equal to 0, which is our base case. So this is one combination, and we will add this combination in answer 2. Okay, so I hope you got a little idea about how this recursion is working. It will be more clear if you make the recursive tree yourself. So just we'll see the code and try to make recursive tree and see how it's working. So see, what we are doing is we have this function combination sum. It will we have n and k. So answer 2, this is a combination, like basically I have changed the names. So this is the combination and this is the final output array. Okay. And here we are passing these, we have created this helper function. Okay. This is the index, right? This is the sum value. Initially sum will be 0. Answer, this, these two vectors we are sending, and k value we are sending. And at last we'll be returning the answer. So what is happening in this helper function? This is the base case. We saw, right? This was the base case. So whenever sum is equal to n and k is equal to 0, we will add the answer vector, whatever the current combination is, and we'll return. Otherwise, if this sum is becoming greater than n, so obviously there is no benefit in going, right? If this is greater than n, so we want a combination which has sum equal to n. So if the sum is becoming greater than n, just stop it. For example, let's say over here, when you are making this answer, you are taking 9 here. So this becomes 9 plus, then you go again take 9 here. So it becomes 9 plus 9, 18. Sum will become 18. And 18 is obviously greater than n. N was 9. So then just return from here, because obviously this will not be a valid combination. This will not be a valid combination. So this is one, you can say base case also. Now what we will be doing is that from index this n, we will be taking this. So see, why we are taking from index till n? Because we do not want to repeat the same number. So over here they have written that each number can be used at most once. So if a particular number you are using here, so again you do not want to use it, right? So from this we'll be sending this I plus 1, and then whatever the current number, let's say I you are choosing, so that you will add in the sum, and k minus 1 you will do. So right, once you have done this, now see here backtracking comes into action. How backtracking? Because let's say over here you have made a recursive call. First of all, from 1 to, let's say this is your current answer, right? This is the current combination vector. So for this position you have taken 1, right? So you will add it in here. So and you will make the recursive call for the next position, for the next position. But now once you come from the recursive call, right, once you come from the recursive call, you want that here 2 comes, right? So you will be popping this 1 from here, because now you want that 2 should be the first digit, because you have to try from 1 to 9. Any digit could be the first number. So that's why first we add it, we make the recursive call, and once then we pop that number, because we want that second number. Like again this for loop will go and it will go for the second number. So this is how this is working. So just try dry run once this code, and I hope you understood the problem. It's kind of tricky, but it's very interesting problem. So if you found the video helpful, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.